Buenos dias, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video. Welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. For the newcomers, my name is Didi Taihutu, yes, the guy that went all in a couple of years ago and started traveling the world with his family. In today's short TA video, again talking about the Bitcoin price, also looking at Ethereum, showing you three other really cool charts that are going to tell you where are we going to go with Bitcoin now. Is this the top or are we going to go much higher? Will we see a pullback first? These charts will exactly tell you where we are and where we will go. I hope you also enjoyed yesterday's TA family video, yes, that one, where we showed you how we were followed by the French television. If not, you need to watch that one as well. Let's keep it short, Didi, because I slept a little bit longer. I needed some rest. I need some fresh drinks because it was pretty busy, hectic the last couple of days. Guys, let's jump into the first chart before I start to talk and to ramble on again too long. Bam! This is the first chart, guys. This is the 4-hour chart. Like you can see on the 4-hour chart, I will minimize the bam bam and this one over here. But like you can see on the 4-hour chart, I told you guys at this point, I drew that yellow line, we will probably go up and then come sideways and then make the next move. Okay, we went down a little bit more, like you can see. So I expected it's a little bit more like this, but we went down to this area over here where we are touching and finding support on this line. This red line has been a line of support and resistance through history. Like you can see, the moment we break it, it becomes support over there. Maybe I should draw it. Maybe it's more clear if I draw it. I always forget to draw it, man. Didi, wake up. So you know, you see support over there, we go up, support over there, we go up, support, and then when we break it, it becomes resistance over there. We try to break it again, resistance, we come down. And that's how it always moves, guys. So this line, the moment we break to the upside, then we expect this line, bam, to come become support. We go up, and then again, bam, it became support. A lot of drawing. Let's delete those lines because that's like a little bit ugly, but you understand what I'm saying. This line is a line that becomes support every time, again and again. So important line. And if we keep that support of this line, yes, I still expect this move upside to the upside because we need to reach it to 67,000-68,000 US dollar, and it's still the fifth wave, which could even go and extend to 74,000 US dollar. So let's just not freak out, zoom out, see the bigger picture, and trust in the support over there. For the people that yesterday wanted to I told how to stop and exit your trade, that was the short flag, that was the moment to exit. You would have made with the bam bam indicator a profit. Let's say you get in late, let's say you get out late, a 4.9%, let's say 5% times 10, a 50% profit yesterday with the bam bam indicator. So beautiful call by the bam bam a little bit earlier. Like you see down here, we crossed the white line at that point, even before the green flag, before this moment, good entry there. We crossed again, we saw the short flag, we crossed downwards, good exit, 5% leverage of then 50% profit, bam. Let's jump into the next chart, guys. This one over here. I need to wait because I promise you every time I want to look at Ethereum, I didn't look yet. So let's take a look at Ethereum. Look, Ethereum also moving beautifully upwards. The target for me is still 2,600 US dollar. We are already at 2,400 US dollar because of the breakout that we saw on this chart. We said we are going to go to 2,600 US dollar, another $200, and we reached that target. The bam bam already called it over there, and we called it again over there. We see it, it's crossing the yellow stepping line, it's closing above the yellow stepping line. We see a green dot appearing on the chart, huge area of green hills and grass where the bulls want to play around. The bam bam is crossing the white line, first indication, second indication, third indication, green line on top, fourth indication, flag, fifth indication, closing above the yellow stepping line, sixth indication. So that's six indications and confirmations of taking that long trade, which would have given you an Ethereum as well, guys. Bam, we go in there. Did I say fucking again? We are still in the trade because we didn't close. Already 15%, guys. With a leverage of 10, that's a 150% profit in Ethereum. The question you want to ask me, how high is Ethereum going to go in this bull run? I know that you want to ask this. In my opinion, Ethereum can easily, but very easily reach 5K. But if we look back in history, in the speed that Bitcoin went from 20 cents to 20K to 60K, if you compare that speed to the Ethereum, how Ethereum went from 20 cents to $100, $500 to 2K, that was 30% to 20% faster than Bitcoin. So if Ethereum would be repeating the run that we have seen the last couple of years in Ethereum and Bitcoin, so if it would be copying that run, wait, I will do it like this, bam. So if Ethereum keeps performing like this, 20% to 30% faster than Bitcoin, then we could reach easily 5K, even easily reach 10K still in this year. Because if we perform the same way that Bitcoin performed, from 2K to 10K to 20K to 60K, and then 30% to 20% to 30% faster with Ethereum, we would reach 10K this year with Ethereum. That's how easy it is. I am not saying that is going to happen. I don't have a glass ball, but it is an option in Ethereum. So that's why I am also invested in Ethereum. Bam! You heard it here. Diddy believes that we could go to 10K Ethereum if we copy the move that Bitcoin did, but then 20 to 30% faster, like we were shown in history. Okay, back to the charts. We are also going to look at this one over here. This is the TikTok indicator. For all the newcomers in the industry that don't know what leverage trading is, we have the TikTok indicator. It looks like this. It looks like a green square like this here. That's the bull. You buy. This cross, you sell. You buy. And you wait for the crosses. So that's how easy it works. We use it for spot trading, but because of the multiple factors of now that indicators that are going to show you, you know, the confirmations that you can also leverage trade with the TikTok, we still prefer the spot trading because it's more easy for a beginner. And then when you are like feeling a little bit more secure with spot trading, then you evolve to leverage trading. But here as well, this was the moment to buy. You see the green area appearing, you see this green thing, you can see the red triangles going into the green triangles. So that's a lot of confirmations, a closing above the yellow stepping line to take that long. If you would have taken that long, then you would have made a profit as well here. Let's take, let's say we go out here late, still 1%, leverage of 10, 10%. We need to aim at 2% a day, like I said in yesterday's video. Yes, I am going to make a video why I say 2% a day and why I believe it's possible. But like you can see, in this day, you already could make 10% just by using the TikTok indicator to buy and to sell. 10% is already 5 days. Easy peasy. Guys, if you want to sign up to this whole Bam Bam indicator, TikTok indicator, please use the links down below the video. Go to the Discord server, you will find the prizes. You will find even people helping you with all the information. You can find everything out there. And then when you sign up to the TikTok indicator, this is the video from yesterday, then please use our links, because these links that are down below every video, if you click here on show more, you get these links, the special offers, Prime XBT bonus 50%, the Bybit bonus $600 bonus, the Dudex bonus $300 bonus, all these bonuses just by clicking these links. And it's not about the bonus only for you, because you click the link, you trade through our referral link in that exchange, we make some fees on the back end, and those fees fill up a fund that we use to help poor people all over the world, like you could see in the video yesterday. We build schools, we buy wheelchairs, whatever is needed for those people that we can give, we do it because of you clicking these links. That is why you become part of the huge Bitcoin family, to make profits, but to share a small percent of those profits without you even realizing you are sharing it, because you're just doing what you always do, trading. We will be earning bit on the back end as the Bitcoin family, you included, some fees that we share. Okay, guys, too much talking, Candidi. What do we have more? Oh, yes, here, Twitter. I was on a podcast show with Laia Halpern, really beautiful woman, but also really cool woman to follow in crypto. She does a lot of good work for Bitcoin, blockchain, and lifestyles. We did an interview. If you want to look at it, please go to her Twitter, and you will find two faces, one beautiful one, the beauty and the beast on the same image. Check the interview. It was a 44-minute interview, a lot of cool knowledge in it. So yeah, really cool. Bam, let's go into this one. Plan B. Really cool thread again. The stock-to-flow model is very simple. S2F model assumes that scarcity, $21 million cap of Bitcoin, and the halvings drives demand and value. The stock-to-flow model estimates Bitcoin capitalization will continue its straight-line historical path, first toward the market cap of gold, $10 trillion, then to real estate, $100 trillion. So, what does he mean? You see this line? This is Bitcoin. You can see here the Bitcoin cluster, the first, the two, second cluster, the payments, the e-gold. You know, you can see all the Bitcoin clusters that is walking through in the last 12 years. And you can see the red one here is the target of real estate, and this is the market cap of gold. We are coming closer and closer to that gold market cap, 10 trillion. We are at the moment at 2 trillion. We could go to 10 trillion in the next couple of years and then to 100 trillion. And what do you think that that would do to the Bitcoin price if we only have 21 million Bitcoins? That is the biggest question. Of course, I can tell you that if we would have this shitload of money flowing into the Bitcoin industry, like a market cap of 100 trillion, $1 million Bitcoin price is nothing. That is what we believe as Bitcoin community, that we can surpass the gold market cap, that we can surpass the real estate market cap, that we can surpass all the market caps all over the world. At least that is why I wear these cool Bitcoin t-shirts every day of my life. And I have a Bitcoin tattoo. If we don't succeed, the tattoo stands for Bacardi Coke, big boobs, beaches, everything else that is beautiful in life, with the B. Let's jump into the next shot, guys. I have one more shot for you. This one. How do I get there? I need to do it like bam. This one, charts BTC, dollar cost averaging into Bitcoin. If you would have dollar cost average into Bitcoin from 2017, in total, in average, you would have been paying now $4,680. So that means if you spend the same US dollar amount every Monday, starting from the first Monday of the year. So every week on Monday, you buy a little bit Bitcoin, in average, you would have paid $4,600. If you would have started in 2019, you would have paid $8,500 on average. Every Monday, just a little bit. In 2020, $11,900. If you even started in 2021, you would have paid $44,000. You would still be in profit if you just bought a little bit of Bitcoin every Monday of the year 2021. It doesn't need to be a full Bitcoin, even if you bought 10% of Bitcoin or 1% of Bitcoin, you know, like 0.001 Bitcoin or 0.0 Bitcoin, one Bitcoin. All doesn't matter. The average price you accumulated Bitcoin would be 44,000, 11,000, 8,500. So you would all be in profit. Really cool chart. And this one, again, a really cool chart. So many charts today, Didi. I would make the video short. I'm not succeeding again. But you can see the Bitcoin valuation. This one is made by Fidelity. You can see that if we would continue doing what we are doing, this blue line over there, bam, that is around $100,000. Yes, if we would follow this growth curve, we would easily reach the $100,000. We are now at $60,000, even at $65,000 already. So this $100,000 is not that far away anymore. And then yes, of course, we could go a little bit sideways till we touch this pink line again at this level, so a little bit below $100,000 would there be the pullback. So you understand what I'm saying? Maybe you're not understanding what I'm saying. Maybe I should do it like this. So maybe it's more clear if I draw the line like this. So we would be going in, we would be going up above the line, and then we would come down to the line, and then we will go up to the line, you know, and then this line would be around $1 million, and this line there, bam, would be around $8,500,000, and this line would be by bam, $71 million. But we could also just follow this pinkish line, there's a little bit less steep, and we would still end up way above the $1 million. Okay, I think now I covered everything I needed to say today. I want to say way more. I don't have the time to say way more. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you didn't enjoy the video, give the video a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you will be notified every time again that we make a video, I make a video, we make a video, whoever makes the video. And please leave a comment, as I love to respond to your comment. I wish you an amazing, I don't even know what day it is anymore. God, Didi, man, what is this? Thursday. I wish you an amazing Thursday. I wish you a beautiful day, guys. Always remember, Bitcoin is really important, but always remember to zoom out in Bitcoin now and then. Zoom in at life. Try to enjoy every single minute of the day, as that is exactly what life should be about. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please the thumbs up, many thumbs up, and please watch the video of yesterday where we as a family spend a beautiful day being followed by French television, part of becoming a huge documentary on the biggest French television broadcast out there, bigger than CNBC. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you tomorrow again. Bam!